Welcome to the show, folks. Oscar and I from Detroit are so happy you could drop in. Listen, when you're on the ice for these tough guys in the National Hockey League, it's like you're on the ice for an octopus. Right, Darcy? Some super saves. Starting with MVP Jose Theodore. Stung a bit, eh, Jose? Hey, you can't stop them all. The Sharks' Nabokov. Roberto Luongo. You know, I saw this kid at the prospects game. He played for Bobby Orr, and I thought he was Patrick Waugh. Brian Dufault watched the club on this stage. Felix the Cat making his moves. From the Kootenay Ice, rookie Danny Blackburn. Corey Schwab, hey, you think Corey had it tough? He fills in for Cujo last year, now he's backing up Brodeur. Nashville's Mike Dunham. Manitoba Moose, Johan Hegberg. Gold medal winner, Martin Brodeur. Beauty. Senators, Patrick Maline. Yeah, You gotta be tough to be a goalie. You gotta stand in there, stop pucks, and keep your eye on who's coming. Hey, sometimes they try and they win an Academy Award. The catch came back here. Look at Patrick. You know, folks, I know how to stop all this. Guaranteed. Put the pipes back in. When I played the pipes in and the player tried to crash the net, we'd steer him into the pipes. And I'll tell you, he didn't try it a second time. Hey, this is a new way to get a goalie. I don't get it. You run the goalies like there's no tomorrow and they still can't score. Hey, get my glove off. Watch them help me get Hermie's glove off. Now here's Defoe and Lalime, a little disagreement. Patrick, get that mask off first. Put the old biscuit in the basket, starting with my buddy Jerome McGinley. Listen, they didn't give him the MVP. Are you kidding? 50 goals, unbelievable. Jerome McGinley, the MVP as far as I'm concerned. Go, Jerome! And he said there's no more goal scorers in the National Hockey League. Then how come Jerome got 52? I guess he learned it from Kamloops. Hey, here comes number 50. Way to hammer it, Jerome. From the Drummondville Vautier, Daniel Bière. From the Swift Current Broncos, master of the wrist shot, Joe Sakic. Mighty Mouse, Sergei Samsonov. Yemi Yeager, watch the look on McCabe's face after this one. From the Guelph Storm, Todd Bertuzzi. Sudbury Wolves, Mike Fisher. Boston College's Bill Guerin. Rookie of the Year, Dan Heatley. It's the old, how's she going? Now watch this, off Scott's head and head. Hey, I'm glad he's facing that way. Where is it? Where is it? Why, it's in the net. Somehow I don't think Patrick agrees with this penalty shot. Rob Ray is a man of many talents. Kai is a little camera shy here. Even the best do it. Imagine if this was a winner in overtime for the Stanley Cup, boy. Pat Quinn says, Corey, you screw up one more time, you're going to New Jersey. What's he doing here? Look out, Malik! And McCabe gets a little face wash from Billy Tibbetts. Hey, looks like Ty's not too worried about green hair. The in-laws, Tucker and Carson. Tucker and Carson again. Look out! Gilly falls down again.
Now, this is how not to look cool in warm-up. Darius, what are you doing here? Roenick just loves those goal scorers. Is that his job? You have the whole rink to shoot in. Hey, this is what's coming, folks. Hands on the helmet. Hey, you had a beat all the way, Darian. Coach McTavish says, George, you're out for a month, and how did you get hurt? Did Morrison must have been a soccer player. Easy goal for Brent Hall. Right time, right place. Max never gives up.
All right, now we're going to start the playoffs. Boy, I love the playoffs, let me tell you. Separates the men from the boys. Leafs, Islanders, a war. That's the way the playoffs should be played. All right, you ready? Let's go.
Leafs and the Islanders, Cujo, the eyes of a warrior. A lot of hate in this series, even though they didn't play each other much. Folks, it's playoffs and they take no prisoners. Silky smooth, Ty Domi sings home the winner. Game two, and they're still hitting. Cujo is a rock. McCauley's Johnny on the spot for the winner. He did it again. Game three back at the island, and there's no letting up. Hey, think the fans don't like hits? Watch in the background. Watch the fans after Sundin gets hit. Hey, it's no contest, though. 6-1, Islanders. Hey, believe me, folks, Shane is not asking Webb, hey, you know a good place to go for dinner? They think not. Game four and the Leafs weren't going down easy. Leafs down by one, and late in the third, it's the old wraparound by Corson. I don't know about this one. A penalty for sure, because the cage didn't touch the puck, but a penalty shot, I don't know. Nonetheless, it's a penalty shot, and Bates sings it home. Tough way to lose, though. Eric says, relax, coach, relax. Bawango! Boy, playoff hockey is tough, huh? Finish your checks, and this is what can happen. McKinney with a blaster from the point, the Leafs win easy, 6-3. Hey, game six, and you're right, there's going to be fireworks in this game. Osgood and Cujo are just terrific. Can't stop them all, eh, Cujo? Things get a little testy at the end of the game, and the Isles win 5-3. Game 7, you think they let up a bit, wouldn't you? No way. Yashin scores early. One of my favorites, Green, gets the winner. Cujo and the Leafs win a tough, tough, tough series. Great one to win, tough one to lose. Ottawa and Philly. See, the Flyers were a big favorite in this one. Playoff hockey again. Both goalies playing well. In overtime, Fedorenko gives the old spinorama and backhand. Phillies better enjoy this goal because it's a long time before they score another one. Hey, it's game 2 of playoff hockey, but this series is not as tough as the Leaf Islanders series, I'll tell you. And Lalim was great. Hey, how many times do you see this? The goalie makes a big save, the other team comes down and scores. Fisher with the winner, shorthanded no less. Hey, Ottawa gets their split, and it's back to Ottawa for game 3. The pitchers do, folks, but there's been 58 shots on net, and Fox scores the winner. Hey, it's game 4, and Philly comes out hitting. Lovely. Wade Redden gets the winner and Ottawa wins again 3-0. Philly's been shut out for 3 straight games. Game 5 and there's no tomorrow for the Flyers. It's do or die. Backs against the wall. They've dug themselves a deep hole. It's now or never. Well, you get the picture. In overtime, Ottawa on the power play, and Havlat scores. The Leafs killed him, giving up only 2 goals in 5 games. Now they're off to beat the Leafs. Oh no, not again. Boston and Montreal. Montreal squeaks into the playoffs, and Boston finishes in first place. You know, when Boston and Montreal meet in the playoffs, there's going to be a lot of action. Watch. Great goaltending on both sides, but one signs a big fat contract and the other wasn't signed. Thornton to Guerin and he's tied up at 2. Donald O'Dead with a great shifty move and it's the winner. Game 2 and it's rocking in Boston. Rolston gets his first of 2, and Boston wins in a shootout 6-4. Well, Montreal gets their split, they head back home. Nest. Lots of action. What a save. Gilmore with a beauty. Teco Kogoi with the winner. Is he happy or what? You know, it's hard to believe that Dougie was skating his knee in the ice dock at the start of the year. Nobody wanted him. Who's laughing now, eh, Dougie? Tough guy PJ Stock gets the pros rolling. You'll see PJ a little later in the show doing what he does best. The point gets the winner and things are looking good for the Bees. And this is when Jose takes over. That's two out of three now, and the Bruins come out hard. Montreal wins 2-1. Theodore stones the Bruins. Bruins outshoot Montreal 44-13 and still lose. Guess who the first star was? Game six, Boston. Backs against the wall, no tomorrow, do or die, you know what I mean. Are still red hot. What a save. Yannick Perreault with a one-hander for the winner. Theodore was great, but I'll tell you, Defoe shouldn't have got the blame for this series. He was great too. Yeah, that doesn't even look like Scott. Well, maybe it does. Everybody thought this was going to be a gimme for the Wings. Trevor Linde ties it up at three in the third. Hey, how many times have I said just a shot on a net in overtime? Hendrick scores the winner. No way the Canucks are going to win game two. I know they won't. Hey, everybody knows the way. No way. See what I mean? Shocks of shocks. Vancouver wins 5-2 to go up 2-0. Lovely. Stick a fork in the Wings. They're done like dinner. Not so fast, Kowalski. The terrible towels are going in Vancouver. Hey, maybe it's going to be a sweep. A kiss of death here. Check out the time in the upper left-hand corner. That's all the Wings needed. But best power forward in the league, Todd Bertuzzi, gets a penalty shot. But penalty shots are Hasek's need. Give him the five ball and take it away, eh, Dominic? Game four, Todd still hasn't quit. Cook ties up the game in the third. But in the thirds, it's Stevie Wonder Yzerman giving a great second ever to score the winner. What a guy. Detroit is smoking it, and that's all she wrote for Vancouver, and the Wings start their march to the Stanley Cup. Everybody knows a good goaltender can make a bad team good. But a bad goaltender can make a good team bad. I know. I had a few bad goaltenders
And you know the one, Hardy Astrom. But let's go and see some real good goaltending. I love them. Let's go.
Now, I know all you young goalies out there, I know what you do. You get the tape, you cue a part up here to get you up for the game, right? Well, this is the part. Are you ready? Beauty glove save start with Marty Brodeur. Kozig. Hasek. Markkanen. Abisher. Burke. Dunham. Johnson with a beauty. Marc Denis. Turco. Blackburn. Beauty save. Passmore. Nabokov. Hegberg. Burke again. Kidd. Gojo. Schwab. DePertov. Passmore again. Now's the time for some highlight goals. Wings rookie Pavel Datsyuk goes end-to-end. And there goes the defenseman, Jock. Banana puts on the Jets here. Owen Nolan. That's embarrassing. Drury with a beauty effort. Sometimes you do it yourself, and sometimes you need a little help from your friend. Rookie Mike Gravel fetters a beauty pass to Perreault here. Kozlov to Hall, and Brett makes no mistake. Jaeger to Zubers and in. Turek to Kravchuk to Schantz. Top corner. Ty with a little fake and slides it to Carson. Look out, Ty! Bertuzzi with a beauty here behind the back to Olin. Yes, it's a basin right along the ice. My buddy Brian Berard to Mahota. Hey, Brian, good luck in Boston. Sundin with a spinorama pass to Healy. TVY spins some magic here, folks. Captain Stu Bard with some nice moves. Draper to Fedorov to Shanahan and leads it home. Kovalchuk to Caberle to Heatney. Back to Kovalchuk and a beauty move. Chovanovski to Bertuzzi and he beats Hasek. Tucker to Caberle and he scores. Behind the net, Cleary, nice little feed to Smith. McGilley to Roberts to Reichel, and back to McGilley. Smith takes the man, gets the puck, and beats Carter. Kick on the ice, kid. Roberts to McGilley, back to Roberts, and he tips her home. Party to Comrie and he tips it all. Smith to Comrie, to Carter. Kick on the ice again, kids. now it's the hammer time. You know, folks, I watch tons of minor hockey. You know what drives me nuts? A kid has a chance to shoot and he passes it off. 9 times out of 10, something happens. A bad pass, defense tips it, it bounces over the guy's stick, and there's no shot on net. I want to see a kid hammer the puck. Now, everybody knows who won the Rocket Richard Trophy last year. Tyrone McGillin. He had 52 goals. Now, quick, tell me, who had the most assists last year? You can't, can you? It was Adam Oates with 67, and his team let him go for nothing. Now, the league gives a trophy for the most goals, but not for the most assists. Look, I'm not saying be a puckhead. All I'm saying is shoot the puck when you have a chance, like these guys. Beauty. You know, there was only one 50-goal scorer last year, and everybody asked, why aren't there more goals scored? Well, it's not the rules, it's not the trap, it's not the hucking and holding. Everybody can shoot a puck now, so why is the scoring down? I'll tell you why. The goaltenders are better now than they've ever been. Watch these guys. They're bigger, quicker, and the big equipment doesn't hurt either. If you don't believe me, watch. Young goalies ask me, what's it take to make the National Hockey League? Well, I'll tell you the most important thing is dedication. Kids, let me tell you a story about dedication. In 1996 finals, Colorado was playing Florida, and they're up 3-0 going into game 4. It was a lock that Colorado was going to win game 4 and win the cup. It was a day off for the teams, and the Avalanche Black Aces were practicing at a small rink outside of Miami early in the morning. I decided I'd go down and watch. I was standing by the boards, and at the far end was a goalie taking a million shots. He looked great. He looked like Patrick Roy. And I thought, oh, Colorado's hiding this guy. Who is this guy? I went to the other end of the rink, and the goalie waved to me. I asked the trainer, hey, who's that great kid out there? He looks like Patrick Roy. You know what he said? That's Patrick. Here was Patrick Roy, one game away from winning the Stanley Cup. He played over 60 games that season, and he was still taking shots in practice. He could have taken the day off. No one would have blamed him. But here he was out practicing, taking 100 shots every hour. Now that's what I call dedication, and that's what you need to make the NHL.
Lovely. Hey, the best series of all, Colorado-Detroit. A very wise guy on Hockey Night in Canada said, whoever wins this series wins it all. 7 games, pretty close though. Let's go, Colorado-Detroit.
As any good series, they come out hit to set the tone.
Two of the best goalies in the world, Waugh and Hasek, doing their stuff.
It was 2-2 going into the third, and who does Detroit turn to? Smooth skating, soft hands of Darren McCarty. Watch this beautiful natural Hasek.
Moments to live forever, eh, Darren? Game 2, and they're still hitting. They're keeping each team in the game. In overtime, Drury scores the winner. Hey, Chris, oh, oh, well, another OT winner. It's tied, 1 game each back in Denver, and things haven't changed. Wings have 42 shots in the game, and it's heading into overtime. In overtime, everything goes wrong for Colorado. Bad line change, Olsson shot hits the stick, and the Wings are up 2-1. Colorado wins game 4, and it's 2-2 going back to Hockey Town, USA. Dominic says he's ready, let's go. Patrick's ready too, though. Patrick gets a little help from Brian Wilsey. It's another overtime. Forsberg cruises in for the winner and makes it look easy. Whoa! Colorado is looking pretty. It's game 6, and it's back in Denver, and like they say, Detroit's back is against the wall. Hasek's using his head again. Watch how Patrick raises his glove to show the referee's got the puck. Blow the whistle, blow the whistle. But this time it backfires on Patrick. He wasn't hot dogging, folks. He does it all the time. But I don't think he'll do it next year, folks. Game 7 back in Detroit, the handwrite is on the wall, and there's no stopping Detroit now.
Detroit wins and it's off to the final. Stevie Wonder can't wait. Sens and Leafs, and this guy is right. It ain't no ballet. There's a lot of hate in this series, I'll tell you. Sens win 5-0 and everybody's burying the Leafs. And it's off the bandwagon for the Leafs fans. That's everybody but Carlton the Bear. Game two, rough as ever. Now watch little Darcy Tucker. Is he a warrior or what? Hey, you know they're not going to score 5 goals on Cujo again. And both goalies shine. Tucker puts the Leafs up 2-0. But in the third, Mike Fisher ties it up. In the third overtime, one of my favorites, Gary Roberts, two bad shoulders and all, scores the winner. And everybody's back in the Leafs bandwagon again. Game three back in Ottawa, and Linden has the crowd going. And it's still no ballet. Link's doing his job. Ottawa wins 3-2, and Cujo's not very happy with the interference here, folks. And everybody's off the Leafs bandwagon. Lalime is in his own little world here. He must like the song. You remember liking Slapshot. Roberts never stops working. Cujo's doing his thing. Ottawa 67, Alan McCauley gets the winner. And Leafs fans are on the bandwagon again. That's not a bad jacket. Here's Gary. That guy will fade. What a save. No chance on that one. Although this play looks like it could turn the series for the Senators, no way. It actually becomes a rallying cry for the Leafs. And Ottawa wins the game. Imagine how long it took this guy to make this sign. No, this is a strange series. When a team won, it looked like that was it for the other team. Then the next game, the other team would bounce back. It was a strange series. Cujo and Roberts step up their game. Roberts gets 2 goals. Leafs up by 1, and Todd White gets a beauty to tie it up at 3. Ottawa doesn't get it out, and McGillie gets the winner. Leafs fans are back on the bandwagon again, and you think it's only for money? Just look at Cujo. Is he happy or what? Game 7, and the Leafs are pulling out all stops. Robert still bashing, two bad shoulders and all. What a guy. And Cujo's killing Ottawa again. On a delayed penalty, McGillie gets the winner. Delay, delay, and in. And the cave ices on a nice pass by Roberts. There's that name again.
Leafs win in seven, and no more room on the bandwagon. Carolina and Montreal, two surprise teams in the playoffs. Carolina wins the first game in a breeze, and Stormy's happy. Jacko Koivu looks pretty healthy here. Theodore keeps the magic going. That little guy can move. Koivu gets the winner. You know, Montreal was outshot 46-16, if you can believe it, and they win 4-0. It's 1-1, heading back to Montreal, thanks to Theodore. If you notice, on all these hits, Montreal looks a little small. They got to get bigger next year. My buddy Kevin Weeks and Theodore doing a good job here. In overtime, no chance for a week. You know, you notice a lot of overtime goals are from faceoffs in the corner. Odette is happy to be in Montreal. Game four, and Montreal looks to go up 3-1. Great pass by Dougie Gilmore. The Bears and Habs go up 3-0. Carolina takes over in the third, out shooting them 14-4, and Cole scores a tying with less than a minute to go. Losing those faceoffs will kill you, I'll tell you, and the Canadians are on a slippery slope. Jose has 158 shots in four games, and he's wearing down. And like I said, Carolina's big, and they're wearing down the Canadiens. Kevin Weeks takes the Hurricanes this far, and now Urbig's taking over with his great run. Carolina wins in six games and pours it on. 221 shots in six games, and they go on to meet the injured Leafs. Leafs versus Hurricanes. And as usual, Cujo is Cujo. Irby's not bad either. Getting a goal is going to be tough in this series. Hey, folks, a game of inches. It's playoff hockey. Gets the winner, Leafs up 1-0. It's me and Billy Beaver. I can't believe I wore that tie. No quarter asked and none given. Fastest skating defenseman in the league, Brent Hennigan with a beauty. McCauley ties it up with less than a minute to go. In overtime, a funny goal, and it's 1-1 going back to Toronto with the split they won. Even linesman Ray Scampanella has to keep his head up in this series. Against the Leafs. Their hockey players tougher what? Jeff O'Neill with a beauty black eye, and he's going to be a hero in overtime. Carolina wins game 4, 3-0. Cujo and the Leafs are in deep water, heading back to Carolina. Hey, folks, this is where Curtis Joseph puts on the best display of goaltending of any goalie in the playoffs. Let's just sit back and watch this magic. Tucker scores a winner, and look who's standing in front. Hey, they got one good shoulder between the two of them. My buddy Travis Green is ready, and so is Cujo. Irby's no slouch either. Sundin scores with less than 30 seconds left in the game. In overtime, Leafs cough up the puck, and so long, Leafs. The Leafs lose 3 games in overtime, if you can believe it. And the last game for Cujo as a Maple Leaf. Good luck in Detroit, Curtis. Let's take a look at some of the great plays in the playoffs. You gotta keep your head up in the playoffs. Some old-timers say there's no more hitting in hockey. Bowango! Everybody knows you want to go anywhere in the playoffs, you have to have good goalies. Watch these goalies sparkle. Lovely.
Hey, of course you have to score goals to win, too. Watch these beauties. Bad line change will kill you every time. Beauty. Nothing like scoring a goal in overtime, right, Craig? And there's nothing like playoff hockey. And there's nothing like the finals. It's the finals and I can hardly wait. 6 weeks of taking a pounding and two teams are left standing. Everybody thought this was going to be a David and Goliath match. David had a surprise for Goliath, I'll tell you. Hey, somebody told me that Hasek had $1 million bonus if the Wings won the Stanley Cup. I don't know if it's true or not, but boy, he played like it was. Hey, watch here how he drops his stick and goes after the puck with his blocker. Finally, somebody gets in front of Irby, and look what happens. In overtime, ex-Sault Ste. Marie Greyhound Ronnie Francis gives Carolina their fifth overtime victory. Can you believe it? Hey, but the lucky octopus is back. You know referee Tarasky is going to pick it up. Hey, Darren says, you want to talk to somebody? Talk to me. Brindamore ties the game with the beauty. Wings pot two in the third and win 3-1, out shooting Carolina 30-17. It is Serbi's routine before the game. Leaves his clubs and mats on the bench. Hey, that stuff looks like it's 100 years old. But it stopped pucks, and that's all he's worried about. See? Irby faces 53 shots and keeps him in the game. Carolina's defense pitches in, and I'm telling you, that's a dangerous play. Larionov gets a beauty goal here, and Carolina's overtime winning streak is gone. Hey, Carolina looks ready for game four, though. But unfortunately for them, so is Hasek. Detroit's starting to roll and they win 3-0. Game five, and yeah, they want to close it out evidently. Detroit's fired on all cylinders and Brendan Shanahan ices it into an empty net, but he pays a price. Hasek finally got his cup, boy, and he earned it. It's his last game. He turned down $7 million, if you can believe it. Yeah, and this is Scotty's last game, too. He goes out a winner. Way to go, Scotty. You know, folks, every year I have a tough decision. What goals to cut out, what goals to leave in. I hate leaving them out. Look, I got some beauties here. I want to show you all the good goals, eh? All right, you ready? Hey, and I'll tell you something. Some of these goals raise the roof.
Hey, that's a Bobby Orr spinorama. A one-hander. A Forsberg special. Yes, that is Sundin with the lead. Hey, McCain's not that fast. We sped it up to help him score. Hey, if it was Bobby Orr, we wouldn't have to speed it up, I'll tell you. They're gonna love them in Phoenix. All right, you know what time it is, eh? It's tea time for the sweethearts. If you want to stick around, you're going to see a beauty. PJ Stock, Reed Lowe, you're going to love it. Let's go.
Hey, the only thing I don't like about this fight is Bruins' uniform. Winnie the Pooh. Boy, these guys mean it. Look like trip hammers going. Look at the crowd in the back. Nobody's sitting down, they're all standing up edge, and every guy's standing up, and they say they don't like fights in the National Hockey League. Look at the players in the background. Guy banging the boards there. Hey, these two guys mean it, boy. Two good guys going at it. And like I said in other tapes there, nobody really hurt. Look at the crowd going nuts. Standing ovation for these guys. Boy, you can't believe how tired they are at the end. Two good guys, still going. Nobody hurt, crowd loving it. Players loving it, nothing wrong with it at all. And now we have a strange one, Chris Neal of Ottawa, Pete Pete of Washington. Now watch, Neal's going with the left, Pete's going with the right, right? Now halfway through, they switch. I haven't seen that before, I'll tell you. They're still going, gotta get that helmet off. Well, that's it, get the helmet off. Guy standing in there, little ring around the rosy there. Now watch them switch, see they've switched already. Boy, I haven't seen that too often, you don't see that. Two good guys going. I say that all the time. Nobody hurt. I like that in a fight. Crowd going nuts. Two good guys. Warriors. I love them.
Hey, thanks for watching, folks. Oscar and I are so happy you could have joined us. And now Oscar says McLean's not here. So what he wants you to do, catch!
You know, the Stanley Cup is the hardest championship to win. 6 weeks of playing almost every night. No time for injuries to heal. The guys are playing for keeps, and like I said earlier, no quarter asked and none given. And I'll tell you something, it takes more than talent to win the Cup. And as the players say, who wants it more? And you know, the best example of that is a captain playing hurt. On one bad knee, who scores, blocks shots, and never quits. And that captain is Stevie Eiserman. I love him. The show's over, folks.
All right, let's start with the goals. The putting the old biscuit in the basket. Starting with my buddy, hey, MVP. Sorry. Should have been the V. All right, you tell me when. That's it. That's what I like. That's what I like. Love it. Keep her going. All right? Can make a good team great. Or something like that. A good goaltender can make a good team great. But a bad goal, what is it? A goal, something like that. Whatever it is, it's, should I let that go? No. All right, everybody knows. A good goaltender, my voice is going over there. So let's see some good goaltending. No, that's not good. I got to get some more energy. One more? All right, welcome to the show. Listen, sometimes when you're in... No, I'll do it again. Hey. All right, welcome to the show. You know some... No, I gotta do it again. Welcome to the show, folks. How do you like my... No. Well, that's the show, folks. Hey, Oscar and I are so glad you could join us. Listen, no, then I'm just gonna keep it short, or you want
yeah,
me...
Keep it short.
Okay. Thanks for watching, folks. Oscar and I are so happy you could join us. And seeing McLean's not here, Oscar wants you to catch. And seeing McLean's not here, catch.